Let us start from where we left off when we finished mean sense analysis. This was the current state. This was the goal state. As we saw from mean sense analysis, achieving this goal state is not a very easy problem. However, we can think of this goal state as being composed of several sub-goals. So D on top of table, C on top of D, B on top of C, A on top of B, four sub-goals here. Now we can try to address this problem by looking at one sub-goal at a time. Let us suppose that we pick this sub-goal C on top of D. Given that sub-goal, we can now start from this current state and try to achieve this sub-goal. Now, of course, one might ask the question, why did we pick the goal C over D and not the goal B over C or the goal A over B? Well, one reason is that the difference between this state and that state had to do with C over D. But in general, problem reduction by itself does not tell us which sub-goal to attack first. That is a problem we'll address later when we come to planning. But now the major point is that we can decompose the goal into several sub-goals and attack one sub-goal at a time. Now that we have C over D as the sub-goal, we really don't care about whether A is on B or B is on C. What we are focused on is the other two states, C is on table, D is on table, because those are the blocks that occur in the goal state. So let us now see how mean sense analysis may solve this sub-problem, where we are worried only about the sub-goal C over D and D on table.